Hi, I'm Bob Wise, president of the Alliance for Excellent Education and former governor of the state of West Virginia. And in almost the same amount of time as it takes Michael Phelps to swim the 200-meter freestyle, I'm going to talk about the next set of gatherings that will affect the world, namely the Democratic and Republican presidential nominating conventions that are going to be held over the next few weeks. Now, in this case, we already know the winners of the primary marathons. Barack Obama and John McCain, two very different set of candidates, but they have something in common: the need to talk much more about education, a critical issue for the economic and social future of our country. We have a long history of presidents that have undertaken bold education reform initiatives. The next president will be called upon to take another major step forward to save America's high schools from a dropout crisis that sees over 1 million students a year leaving school. This is a critical time for America's high schools, with grave consequences for our future. If the high school dropouts from the class of 2008 alone had instead earned diplomas along with their classmates, our nation's economy would benefit from an additional $320 billion in wages. That's $320 billion in wages over the working lifetime of these students. Now, there are five things in particular the next president can do to make sure that students are prepared for college or the modern workplace. First, strengthen federal policy and strategically target funding to improve outcomes for all America's students. Second, improve reading and comprehension instruction for middle and high school students. Third, encourage all states to adopt a set of voluntary common standards that are benchmarked internationally so that our students, regardless of where they live, are receiving a world-class education. Fourth, ensure that educators have the support and training they need to improve student achievement. And fifth, develop a single accurate method for measuring graduation rates and create data tracking systems to monitor students' progress. Now, the convention halls in Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Denver are going to ring with promises to do something about our economy. Yet just cutting the dropout rate in half would bring $45 billion a year in new federal revenues and cost savings and create millions more highly skilled workers. You and I may not be traveling to the political conventions, but our children's future may well be riding on what happens there. It's time for all of our presidential candidates to put education at the top of their tickets. After all, the best long-term economic stimulus package for our country is a high school diploma.